students, let us see properties. Properties of this unit. Some few properties. See, first property, the input x of t and its output y of t are related by. Y of t is equal to, by convolution we know, just now I said, right? The relationship between y of t and x of t is, y of t is equal to h of t convolution x of t, which is integral minus infinite to plus infinite h of t x of t minus u h of u, right? It is h of u x of t minus u du. Please correct it in your material, okay? You please correct it in your material. H of u x of t minus u du. Then the system is a linear time invariant system, okay? We have to prove the system is linear time invariant system. If this is the relationship between input and output, then we have to prove the system is linear time invariant system. So see, y of t is given. We have to prove y of t is a linear time invariant system. So to prove this, we have to prove y of t is linear and y of t is time invariant. So to let us do simultaneously, both have, listen here, separate into two columns. Let us do both simultaneously. See, y of t is linear. So in order to prove y of t is linear, we have to prove the condition, right? F of a1 into x1 of t plus a2 into x2 of t is equal to a1 into y1 of t plus a2 into y2 of t. So let us take x of t as a1 into x1 of t plus a2 into x2 of t. Okay? So if this is our assumption, then x of t minus u is the same in x1 t minus u, x2 of t minus u. Let us take y of t, integral minus infinite to plus infinite h of u, x of t minus u we have. So which is a1 into x1 of t minus u plus a2 into x2 of t minus u du. Separate the integral, okay? This is by given, this become y1 of t. This, by this, it is y2 of t. Hence we can say y of t is linear. When can we say y of t is linear? When can we say y of t is linear? When x of t, when this is considered, f of a1 into x1 of t plus a2 into x2 of t is equal to a1 into y1 of t plus a2 into y2 of t, y of t is linear. So in place of x of t, you have to consider this. But there is no x of t here, x of t minus u. Consider x of t, later in place of t, t minus u, substitute this in the integral, separate integral, automatically you will meet y of t is linear. Next you have to prove y of t is time invariant. This is our y of t. What is the definition of time invariant? When t is replaced by t plus k, then y of t will, in y of t, that t will also be replaced by t plus k, right? That is the time invariant definition. So if x of t is replaced by x of t plus k, y of t is equal to t is replaced by t plus k du, right? You compare with the definition given. You compare with the definition given. If this is h of u x of t minus u du, it is called y of t. If it is h of u x of t plus k minus u du, it is called y of t plus k. If this is the relation, this t is y of t. Here t plus k, y of t plus k. So when in x of t, when t is replaced by t plus k, in y of t, t is replaced by t plus k. Hence y of t is time invariant. Very easy. Very easy. By definition, we prove. What definition says? If this t is replaced by some t plus tau, then this t will also be replaced by t plus tau. Okay, hence both conditions are satisfied. Hence the system is a linear time invariant system. Okay, next we have a very important property, second property. Very important property. Okay, if x of t is the input of linear time invariant system with system function h of t, this is a impulse system, impulse response function, right? X of t is input and the system is LTI system. H of t is system impulse response function. Y of t is output, okay? X of t is WSS, etc. Anything given. We have to prove SYY of omega is equal to SXX of omega into modulus of H of omega the whole square. So to go through 5th unit, first you should know 4th unit, okay? What is this SYY of omega? Which is power spectral density function of y of t. What is this SXX of omega? Which is power spectral density function of x of t. Input x of t, output y of t. Okay? So we find relationship between PSD of y of t and PSD of x of t. This gives relationship between PSD of y of t and PSD of x of t. Okay, we know SYY is power spectral density. SXY is cross power spectral density. Okay. Now let us take, we know what is y of t. What is y of t? Being linear time invariant system, this is our y of t. Now in order to get this answer, listen here, let us have a column. We do simultaneously and we get answer. Listen here, let us take in both columns y of t. Okay. Now here I multiply both sides by x of t plus tau. I multiply both sides by x of t plus tau. You may think it should come outside the integral. It can be taken inside the integral because integration is for u. So my t plus tau will not disturb integral. I can take it inside the integration. No problem. Okay. Integration is for u. So I multiply both sides by x of t plus tau. Next I take expectation both sides. Expectation of integration is integration of expectation. You know, expectation is taken only for the random processes or random variables. So here also expectation should be taken for these two terms. It is independent, right? These two terms. Expectation can be taken only for random variables or random processes. So we know E of x of t1 into y of t2 is rxy of t1 comma t2 or rxy of tau, where tau is equal to t1 minus t2 or t2 minus t1. Here I have considered t1 minus t2. T1 is t plus tau, t2 is t, t1 minus t2 is tau. So we know the expectation of x of t1 into y of t2 is rxy of t1 comma t2, which is rxy of tau, where tau is t1 minus t2 or t2 minus t1. Here I have considered t1 minus t2. Okay. And similarly here, it is expectation of x of t plus tau, x of t minus u. Both x, which is rxx, rxx of t1 minus t2, t plus tau minus t plus u, minus of t minus u, t1 minus t2, which is t plus u, h of u du. And the same thing we do here, y of t into, I multiply both sides by y of t minus tau, y of t minus tau. Take expectation both sides, t1 minus t2 is tau. Rx, ryy of t1 comma t2, ryy of tau, where tau is t1 minus t2. Similarly here x, here y. So it is rxy, right? It is rxy. Please correct it in your material, okay? It is rxy. Rxy of t minus u. T minus u, how do we get t minus u? T1 minus t2. That is our tau. H of u du. Okay. Now let us use convolution. What is definition of convolution? Convolution is just integral. First function is replaced by u and second function is replaced by t minus u, which becomes h of tau convolution rxy of tau. First function is replaced by u, second function is replaced by tau minus u, right? T minus u. If it is t minus u, right? You can see they are in multiplication. It is ordinary multiplication. It is convolution. So by convolution, you should know in both way how to write. If it is given, how to write this. If it is given, how to write this. You should know both. Okay. So by definition of convolution, we have got this answer. Let us come this side. So after this step, here it was ready. Listen here. Here it is ready to write convolution. Here we should do some adjustment. Because when first term is replaced by u, second term should be replaced by t minus u or tau minus u. I need negative sign here. But here positive sign. So in order to get here negative sign, let us use substitution. Put u is equal to minus alpha. So du is equal to minus d alpha. Limits will also change. When u takes negative infinity, alpha takes positive infinity. Similarly. So let us use substitution. Now it is ready to listen here. You know properties of integral. Minus integral b to a is integral a to b, right? Minus integral b to a is integral a to b. Okay. Now it is ready to use convolution definition. So when first function should be replaced by minus alpha, second function should be replaced by, right, tau minus alpha. See, h of minus tau, sorry, I hope you can understand. H of minus tau and rxx of tau. So here, if this is replaced by alpha, this is replaced by tau minus alpha. If first function tau is replaced by alpha, here tau is replaced by tau minus alpha. In both way, you should know how to use convolution. Okay, definition, convolution definition. So now we have got both sides. Now let us take Fourier transform both sides. Fourier transform of rxy of tau is, we know Fourier transform of rxy of tau is sxy of omega. Similarly, Fourier transform of h of minus tau is, we know Fourier transform of h of tau t is h of omega. Fourier transform of h of minus tau is h star of omega. Conjugate symmetry property. There is a property in Fourier transform, listen here, which is called conjugate symmetry property. Like in complex numbers, z, z bar, right? It is like z bar. So which is called h star of omega. Fourier transform of rxx of tau is sxx of omega. Similarly, we write here, take Fourier transform both sides. Fourier transform of ryy of tau is syy of omega. Fourier transform of h of tau is h of omega, transfer function. You know relationship between transfer function and impulse response function. Sxy of omega, right? See, I have got second equation here, here first equation. Let us now substitute this xy, first equation, in second equation. Substitute sxy value here. Substitute sxy value here, you will get the required answer. H of omega, h star of omega is, like z into z bar is mod z square. This is transfer function, this is conjugate, right? Conjugate, it's conjugate. Hence, which is modulus of h of omega whole square. So, which completes the property, which is very important, the property, second property, which gives relationship between power spectral density of output and power spectral density of input. Relationship between these two. So if you go through once the property, you can easily understand, okay? See, it's not difficult. So first, you should keep in mind, here you should multiply by t plus x of t plus tau. Here you should multiply by y of t minus tau in order to get answer. In order to get answer, here you should know these two, right? These two. So which is, which completes second property, okay? We shall see next property in the next video, okay? Thank you.